probably the last council hand roller that was in commercial use. And the reason they kept it going, because it was going to dry before it was in a workable condition. So they just got the benefit of it. It didn't see any point in getting rid of it, just to replace it with a new roller when it didn't need replacing. It wasn't fit to be replaced at the time. It's got several years working it, so they used it. I don't think it was any more uneconomical than any other roller. You're like to be on the job early on a Monday morning. I used to return on a Sunday night. The roller was stone cold. It used to take longer to raise steam. So I mean, you used to get up at 5:30 and light the roller up, and cook your breakfast, then go out to the roller and boil it round. And once you had steam raised, you were on the job at 7:30 when the gang arrived. And that went on through the week. You clean the clinker out and push the remains of the fire at the front end of the box and sheet it up and left a bundle of firewood and a bunker full of knobs ready for Monday morning again. And that was the whole job, week in and week out. I didn't live in the van at the weekend, I used to go home because I was quartering. But you had to live in it all through the week and do your own cooking and cleaning. And there was always something to do, you never got bored with it. You took the rough with the smooth. I mean, in weather like this, it was lovely when even sitting in the van and probably peeling potatoes ready for the next night's meal. Giving the van a sweep out, perhaps polishing the kitchen range. But winter times, it was a little bit different. When you woke up in the morning, your bedding was frozen to the side of the van, and the ice on the drinking bucket and the kettle in was froze onto the kettle. It wasn't quite so clever then, and it was pitch dark as well. She got married and my wife travelled in with me for a couple of seasons. My wife knew what she was in for, really. I mean, she had on odd occasions come in and visited me for the weekend, so she knew what van life was going to be like, or at least she had a rough idea what it would be, and she took to it. It went on living apart. The roadworks that we did and the roadworks that take place today. We could work on a main road and have half the road being repaired, and perhaps two cars an hour would come by, no trouble at all.